Okay, we got a different Ben playing and Ben commentating.
A different Ben commentating. So, all right. So, Ben V's setup that he's running, he's got a Decimator with real Admiral
Cherno,
which hit that. The pilot ability there is allows him to change an eyeball to a crit.
At range 1 to 2.
He's playing with Gunner, so if he misses, he gets to reroll. Kylo Ren, I'll show you the Force, which allows you to assign the show you the Force. I'll show you the dark side. I'll show you the dark side, and I'll show you the Force. You get to assign him, I'll show you the dark side card, and have him pull one of his damage cards that has a pilot ability. Then if you hit that guy with a crit, anyone can hit him with a crit, that takes effect. It actually goes behind, it ignores your shields, and you get the pilot problem.
You get the pilot problem.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, problem. That's a good word for it.
Dauntless, if you bump, you can take a stress to what?
Get your action.
Get the action.
You still can take your action after you bump.
Okay. Hotshot Co-Pilot says that if you have a focus, you've got to spend it. If they've got a focus, they've got to spend it. Then Predator, which allows you to reroll one dice unless someone has a pilot skill of two or less, and then you get to roll two dice.
Which there is a two or less on the other
there's
team.
There's several of them on the other team.
No, there's just one. Prototype.
No, isn't that?
Pilot skill.
Oh, sorry. Okay, Countess Ryad, which she says any straight-up maneuver you can do a K-turn on, which is really powerful. Juke, which I forgot what Juke does. You can spin and evade. When you're attacking somebody, you can spin an evade to have them change an evade to a eyeball. And
stealth device, because three defense dice is just not enough for Countess Ryad.
Yeah, you need four. So, but as soon as she takes a hit, she loses it. But that makes sense on Countess Ryad. With four, it's going to be hard to score a hit.
Yes, it is.
And then the TIE X7, which if you do a straight maneuver, three or more, you get a free evade.
Hey, she has a way to get evade so she can use them with Juke.
Yup.
Wonderful.
Well, and also she can K-turn and get an evade.
Yeah, because of her pilot ability.
If she does, three or more. All right, now Sam has, if you've seen previous videos, it's the same setup for this tournament, obviously. He's got Big Bag Biggs, which says that anybody that's within range one of him, you can't target that person. You can't attack him. You must attack Biggs himself. He's going to chain, what Sam's going to do is chain a bunch of his bunch of his ships together so that they're all within range one, forcing people to fire on Sam. Which he'll put Sam at the back, which means someone usually doesn't get a one-range shot on the front guy, which allows him to stay around for a little bit longer.
I just noticed something. There's a hotshot co-pilot on both sides of the table.
Yeah, I wonder what that means. Everybody's spending focus like crazy. All right, so Biggs has Integrated Astromech, which says he can jettison it to absorb a damage. And the R4-D6, which says if you... if you have three or more hits on you that are not evaded, you can cancel them down to two hits and take one stress for each.
For each one that you cancel that way.
Yeah. Prototype Pilot just has the... How do you pronounce it? I always mess that
Chard
up.
Chard and Refit.
Chard and Refit. Okay, which just reduces the point value of the card.
Yep. So he's just trying to make it a cheaper pilot.
Yep, so Captain Rex... I forgot what his...
Hotshot Sabine.
Well, I forgot what Captain Rex does.
Oh, suppressing fire? So basically, if you perform an attack, you assign them the condition of suppressing fire.
Which reduces their attack dice by one, which is kind of powerful. Hotshot Co-Pilot, you must spend a focus. Sabine's
allows masterpiece. Hotshot Co-Pilot, this case.
Yeah. Then two of the same, the Green Squadron pilots.
Snap crack.
Snap crack pop. Yep, there we go. So you've got Snapshot, which says if someone moves, and is within one range one of you, at the end of the movement, you get a two dice. You get to perform an attack against him, which it counts. You basically get two attacks, which is really kind of crazy. Crackshot says cancel and evade. Does that means you have to flip the crackshot over?
You cannot modify the attack dice on the snapshot attack in
any way. Right. Well, it's not in the normal attack. That's why. So.
Well, the card actually says that specifically.
Yeah. And then test pilot.
A-wing test pilot allows it to fit both of the
two EPTs and an extra VPT. So we'll see how this works here. It's interesting that he's lining up the decimator on the exact opposite side of the board. And he's going... Countess Riot is hitting him. That's just really strange. That he's engaging with Countess Riad.
I don't think Countess Riad's just going to run right up the side of the board and joust.
Not.
I can't see him doing that. If it is, that's going to be one dead Countess. Unless you can time it where she's making a hard turn. She's like, nope, not doing it.
Yeah, I know, but he knew. Why did she place him over there? I don't understand.
She's a five.
I know, but they would have placed the one first, and you know they're going to be flying in formation. The one and the threes and the fours.
Oh, yeah. Huh.
So why did he place her all the way over there?
Try to draw them in and get them to... And if you look at the asteroid placement.
Yeah, well...
They have...
There's an open lane down the center. No one.
There is an open lane, but they are very spread out asteroids to try to push people out, not get them, not give them away to... cut around the outside. Oh, I'm not sure that... what do you think about that decimator move? Three hard in?
I don't know about that.
I think I would have done a three bank and tried to get in the middle of that.
Yeah, to give me maneuverability. Because he can't engage. He should not engage the setup directly. He needs to keep himself at range three. So he needs to go in like he's jousting and turn.
Well, I mean, he could also did like a one bank and made him come to him. If he can get them to come through the asteroids and let the asteroids kind of break up the formation, maybe. But, you know, Sam's going to try to get him to come to him.
Yeah, so I'm going to, we'll see what happens here. But if it would, the way it currently is going, I would fly the decimator down past the second asteroid on the left and do a hard turn. And then do another hard turn and run away and keep it range three. So you could pick off the front guy. And start picking them off one at a time.
Well, I mean,
he cannot, with that many ships, five ships, there's no way he can get close. He shouldn't get close because it's too, you know, even though they're, they only have two for their attack rolls, there's still five of
Biggs,
them.
Yeah. Biggs has three. Biggs is not really the offensive piece here. And they're coming.
Yep, he's going to turn down the center here, so.
Well, he's coming straight up, so we'll see where he makes his turn. And I would suspect he would just turn on the other side of that asteroid and come out.
Well, but I don't think you can get the whole formation around the asteroid, do you?
Oh. Yeah, this might make some ugliness in the way the maneuvers go. I don't know.
Let's see.
I don't know. I mean, the key is you want to try to break the formation apart so you can kind of take it apart piece by piece. But that's
or like I was saying, stay at the edge.
Yeah. That's going to be really hard to keep right
or
at the
somehow
edge.
Get behind it, right? Because not all of them have K turns.
No, they all have Ks.
They all have Ks? Okay.
They're all different. Yeah. Which is going to make it really awkward to flip this formation around. Countess Riad's in a hurry.
What is she doing?
She's doing a 5K.
Ah.
A green 5K.
Oh, and she gets an evade for that.
Yes.
Because of her ability, and then that's it.
I don't know that I might have just kept it going straight.
Yeah, I don't know. We'll see. It's hard against this Sam's build because it's so beefy head on. You've got to stay out of range one. Got to be in range two or three. Three is hard, but it's still better than range one. He just hits you with so hard with the snapshots.
I think you got the going through the asteroids correct there. So the asteroids aren't going to be the problem. At least for Ben, they're not. This is a hard build to play against.
So it is true. Kylo Ren, you have to be within range. You have to be able to take the action.
To use the action, yeah.
Interesting.
That's a lot of points on that decimator.
That is.
63 points.
My goodness. Yeah, well, Countess Riot's pretty beefy with four defense dice. That's just really, really good. Plus she gets the evade. She can take an evade plus four defense. Yeah, that's amazing.
It's not quite Centaur fail, but it's pretty good.
Yeah. She does not have the evade action.
She does not normally have the evade action.
Yeah, okay. So she has to move three. So she's zippity-doo-dying it all the time.
Yeah, she's got to keep the gas down to win this.
But since she can flip, she can shoot past folks all the time. Maybe that's what he's gonna try to do with her is get it in, slip past the formation with a 5K turn.
Well, let's see how well he can negotiate this turn here and see if he can hold his formation together. Because that's what he's trying to do. He's trying to turn in there.
How many points does Countess Riot base, I wonder?
Countess that's an excellent question. I'll tell you in a sec.
All right, Dosey doing around the asteroid.
Right, it's 34.
Okay. Base.
Which makes her a pretty beefy ship.
Yeah.
Even.
I guess that K-turn ability is pumps
TIE X7 minus her by 2.
Oh, okay. That's why.
That card's ridiculously good. Minus 2 points and you get evades.
Yep. Oh my gosh.
She's not
in range 3.
They're not going to be engaging at range 1, so. There's also no Palpatine in this list. I don't know, but you take Hotshot Gunner and a Hotshot Copilot and Gunner over Palpatine?
I don't particularly see the huge value over Hotshot Copilot. So I'm spinning a focus. I'm spinning a focus, and it's going away anyway.
That's 9 points and 2 crew slots.
Yeah.
For Hotshot. So that's almost... Do you think that's really better than Palpatine?
I don't think so.
Because, I mean, that's a... If you don't do damage, you get to reroll. And perform a new attack. And Hotshot Co... I mean, there's some synergy between the two cards. Don't get me wrong. But I just don't see it being better than Palpatine.
Yeah, I don't either.
Because, so, Gunner... So, the reason these cards work well together is you shoot someone with Hotshot, you force them to spend their focus token, and then on the Gunner shot, if they evade all your results, you get a Gunner, and they don't... Hopefully, they don't have a... have an evade left.
Yeah.
It'll be interesting to see if you see a build like this with a TIE Aggressor or two. With TLTs.
Ooh, is that 3 hits? Oh, and he's chained.
I mean, I honestly, this build, I'd rather see a normal... Kind of feels like a little bit of an
awkward. He was using... What was he using for reroll?
Predator.
Oh, he has Predator. Oh, he's in range?
Yep. With the Decimator?
Oh, yeah.
Oh, yeah. He's doing what you said. He's staying at range 3. Okay. Did the Decimator accomplish getting work done?
Who knows?
It looks like he did.
Oh, he did the, I'll show you the force on him. Wonder which one he did.
No, that was, that's suppressing fire.
Suppressing fire, okay.
Who's the first one to shoot? The Decimator took a shot. Don't think the Decimator did anything.
Wow. He might have used, what's, is it crack shot? Where he probably used crack shot to evade something. Oh, no, he did.
Oh. Did he have a Kylo on him?
I think so, yeah. That's what I was saying.
Oh, nice.
So I wonder which one he did. Maybe no fire? I don't know. It's hard to tell.
Yeah, I would definitely want to go for no fire.
Well, it also, I might have been tempted to do pilot skill zero because then Predator kicks in.
Yep.
Right?
The only problem with doing a no fire one against a Green Squadron pilot.
You shouldn't. You save those until we're the end.
The problem is the way Blinded's pilot skill reads is I got a shot on the prototype too with Counter Triad. God, too bad he couldn't have got both those shots on the same guy and just took them off.
I know,
the table.
I don't understand why they didn't do that. I mean, he definitely...
Did he have range?
He had range on both of them, yeah.
Well, it depends. Riot, I don't... I think he barely had three on these guys. If it's the one that's on the left-hand side? Right-hand side.
Yeah, but either the two front ones, I would have... Yeah, I would have concentrated fire. They should have been able to... With the
we're assuming that...
With Rear Admiral, he had... He's range three of both of the two front ones.
I wanted to say, yeah, with the Rear Admiral, but if he had put the Kylo on the one on the right, and then Rayad had measured and didn't have range to that one, that would explain why he went for the prototype, because maybe that was the only one he had range on with Rayad.
I know, but...
You get what I'm saying?
Yeah, I know, but I still...
If you've got Kylo on that Green Squadron pilot, wouldn't you want to shoot
it? Yeah, but why would you put... Never mind. I guess he was... It makes more sense to put Kylo on him because it's a beefier ship than prototype pilot.
Well, it's got more points on it. Yeah. It's got the snapshot, it's got crack shot.
Yeah.
Stopping those cards from working is definitely more important than stopping the blocker from shooting.
Pew, pew.
I mean, a blocker may actually never... take a shot, to be honest.
That's true.
So.
Doing the bump.
Yeah, I mean, the blocker isn't there to take shots, and he doesn't have cards to make his shots more effective. So you'd want to get the value out of blind. But I think Blinded Pilot, if I'm not mistaken, the snap would get used up on snapshot and get flipped over, and then he would be able to perform an attack with his normal attack. He would lose the snapshot, though.
Hmm. Okay, let's see what the formation does. It's going to be interesting to see what the move is. If I'm playing the Decimator, I think I would probably just move forward one. To keep myself at range 3 or 2. See how far... Oh, he's coming in. Yep, definitely.
Breaking out the damage check so I can read it.
He's coming in at... Oh, he's doing a K-turn. Oh, that's weird. Not a K-turn. What did he just do? That was crazy.
Ooh!
Look at this. Hopefully, Countess Raya did a 5K turn. That's what I would have done. What is a blinded pilot?
I don't know how that.
You cannot perform attacks. That is an attack.
You cannot perform attacks. After your next opportunity to attack, even if there's no target, flip this card face down.
Okay. But I don't think that counts for... Because it only triggers within range 1. It would if you were in range 1.
If you had a legitimate attack at range 1, With Snapshot,
so we were talking about using Kylo Ren to with Blinded Co-Pilot. How blinded that would pilot. Work. Blinded Pilot. Sorry, Blinded Co-Pilot.
Blinded Co-Pilot. That sounds like a bad situation.
He bumped. Oh, well.
Is that in the 3.0 damage deck?
No, 3.0 damage. They would do that. Come out with version 3.0 of the base set to make everybody buy the damn things again. That's a guaranteed sell for everyone who plays X-Wing. That's ridiculous if they do that.
Can they come out with a scum ship, an Imperial and a Rebel in it?
Yeah, well, no, you really can't play it as a standalone if you do it that way.
Well, if the ships are all comparative.
Well, is that not what just we're gonna one get the... against one. No.
Oh, man.
What is he doing? He moved himself out. I would have just done a one. I would have done a one forward to keep myself within range.
Hey, Ben?
Yeah?
Just so you know, there isn't a TIE X-7 on the Decimator.
No. No,
did
not.
He didn't keep it?
He didn't keep it. That's why.
Why?
Exactly. I don't know. I would have done a one forward or one turn or one easy just to keep me within. As long as you're within two, you're fine. One is bad.
You need to keep shots on your... on the enemy.
Okay, so now Snapshot's coming in.
And Snapshot's on Riot. Oh, Lord, no.
Snapshot. But she's got the four defense dice, so let's hope. Roly-poly. Oh, no, he didn't do Snapshot.
You know, she's
because it was the prototype pilot. The other ones aren't within range one, unless they forgot to do it.
Well, one of them may have had it because of blinded pilot.
Oh, I didn't know he Rear Admiral got two hits on him. Wow.
Yeah, on the prototype pilot. But the prototype pilot's not going to get shot. This turn.
No. Well, no. Somebody did damage last turn to Rear Admiral.
Yep.
I didn't notice that. And he's lost his ability to do Kylo, right?
Yeah, because he's out of range, yeah. He got suppressing fire on. Oh, no! When you've got so few attacks. Oh, that's so bad.
Countess Riot has suppressing fire?
Yeah, suppressing fire on Riot. And Riot's the only one that's going to get a shot.
That's not good.
You're taking... I would have been rolling four red dice, now I'm rolling three. That's a big deal. 25% of his attack went away.
Yeah.
It's actually worse than that because it's...
No, it's good. 3-2, right?
Well, yeah, but he's probably going to be able to get a range one.
Oh, yeah. Well, no, he's got to hit big. He doesn't have a range one.
Oh, no. Okay, yeah, you're right, too. That's it. Yeah, it's even worse.
Well, the good thing is, I thought Riot get to attack before Biggs? Riot got to attack before the...
No, she did damage on Biggs.
Oh, she did damage on Biggs. So she did get to attack beforehand. Okay. He probably popped his integrated astromech.
That's only for damage cards.
Oh, so he hit shields. Okay, yeah.
He put a point to the shields.
See, he's... Now the Decimator, he's still two turns away from being in range.
He's going to do a three hard...
And Countess Riot better do a five flip so she gets the evade, or at least a three. Well, three would probably bump her.
I think a five flip's the only way she's going to...
Four flip or a five flip. But I would do five just in case. And that's going to require all them to do crazy stuff like that as well. Yeah, it's kind of funny because you got so many ships. Sam puts the movement dials in the formation on the right hand side.
Probably not a bad idea if you're flying formations.
No, not a bad idea. Unless he scatters and then it's a pain.
Yeah, that kind of goes to heck if he scatters them.
Okay, let's see what he's doing.
Okay, let's see what the dials look like. I'm pretty sure they've got them checked, and yeah, about that.
Have we got the Countess yet?
No, Countess is gonna be... I don't know. Do you know who has initiative?
I don't.
Because Countess is moves at the same speed Biggs does.
Oh.
So I don't know who will move first, Countess or Biggs. Oh, they're doing a three flip.
Well, they're expecting her to do the K turn too, which makes sense.
Yep, definitely.
Do you do some shenanigans with Captain Rex and try to get a block on?
I don't know. Do all of them have K-turns?
Oh, yeah.
Oh, yeah, he is doing some shenanigans.
That'll still probably get a shot in. Depending exactly where Riot lands.
So Captain Rex, what did he do?
He just used his maneuver template in a weird way. And yes, he's doing the K turn to try to...
He has a K turn on that one? That's crazy.
No, that was a one hard. Oh. And he barrel rolled
backwards.
To try to to get the block on. Oh, what? He did! No!
He didn't do a five.
No, he did a... I think he did a... Was that not a five? I don't know.
That was a four. That was not a five.
Oh, no.
That Countess took damage, so her stealth device got... Stealth device went.
Yes, but did you see that? Mm,
yeah.
That one got a snapshot on him. Oh, no. He probably used his crack shot to push that through. Oh, man. And Biggs is going to... Well, Biggs isn't going to be an issue this turn. Oh, no.
And Riot gets no shots.
You know, I never thought about Countess Rex as a great blocker, but Jesus... That one hard in a barrel roll puts him in some crazy spots.
Yeah, he disengaged with his heavy hitter. It's bad. He's still... I don't think he's...
He's not got... I mean, the thing about Ben's list is it's not... It's got to get shots.
Yeah, he shouldn't have tried to turn around.
He needs to have his ship staying in because he's got... So Ben... has six red dice opposed to 11. And Snapshot's a pseudo four.
Yeah.
Because there's two copies of Snapshot, so that's potentially another four red dice in his list. You've got to make those work. You've got to make your six work for you. You can't let the guy outclass you by up to 15 dice.
Yeah. Well, he's within range three. I'll show you the dark side too.
Oh. What on Biggs?
Yeah. I don't know who has the, I'll show you the dark side, but.
I mean, how many?
Yeah, I guess he had a shot on Biggs.
It had to be on Biggs.
Through the asteroid, plus range three.
Push a crit through, though. People could the fires come? Ooh.
Oh, jeez. Oh, jeez. We'll see here, Countess Ryan. Does she get another turn? She gets to shoot first, so she'll get one more turn, I think.
No.
No? She's... Oh, wow. Now 5 against 1. This is it.
There's some damage scattered out there, but oh, that's not good. I mean, Katasraya did some work and broke up the formation, but I don't think it's going to be enough.
Yeah.
I mean, they're stressed. They're at awkward angles.
Yeah.
But A-Wings have amazing dials.
Yeah, but the... Okay, so... Rear Admiral needs to hit a crit on Biggs. That's what's got to happen here. So it happens. Either that or...
Biggs needs to get out of this fight quickly.
Yeah. I wonder what's happening. Boy, it's a lot of dials to set up, right?
It really is.
I think half the game we've been sitting here waiting for dials to be laid down.
Oh, you've seen me play 6 TIE Fighters, haven't you?
I know, yeah.
Didn't I make your Falcon go away real fast that way?
Yeah, I was playing double Decimators and I went straight for you.
And I just wiped one off the table. Yeah. Like turn 2.
Turn 2.
Youngster exposed. Gotta love it.
I think I was still playing Decimator Whisper.
Maybe.
I can't remember. It was a long time ago. I think it was my 3rd or 4th match. Oh, I've got yards. Ah, jeez. That's what happens when you wait for this many dials.
Yeah. Take a nap in the way.
Yeah. Okay. All right.
Swarms are a thing, man.
They are. This one's pretty effective, too. Usually they're brittle, and you have to be done first, right? You've got to get out there, unload, and get some ships off the board. But this one seems to be pretty resilient.
Yeah. There's some shenanigans in this Rebel list that makes it really hard to deal with. I would say if that Decimator has a, what the heck's that card called? Has that 2-point torpedo, it makes an asteroid go away. This is the time to shoot it. Take that rock off the table. Give everything in range 1 a point of damage.
He's only got 1 in range 1, so.
Of this asteroid.
That asteroid. Oh, yeah. I mean, I haven't used torpedoes on him before.
The seismic torpedo would be really... He has a torpedo slot, right?
Yeah. How many points is...
2.
2... It, 2 points for that.
The challenge about it is it's range 1 to 2. So you need to be, well, a Decimator, you know, God forbid if I took a damage.
That's true.
I mean, if you're fighting like TIE Fighters or A-Wings, 1 point of damage guaranteed, past all that evade, that just gets to ignore all that evade crap they have, that's a big deal.
Yeah.
You know, they're rolling 3 evade dice. They're going to... So...
He's sticking Biggs out there. I mean, he knows where the...
A seismic torpedo would be beautiful right about now.
Yes. He knows where the Decimator's going. And he's getting closer to him. That's crazy. You'd be crazy!
I mean, the Decimator... Decimator dial's not wonderful.
No, it's not.
A heck of a lot of options there. It usually isn't that big an issue because Decimators are so tanky, and with a 360, they can kind of go where they need to go and still get work done.
I hope you took a target lock against him.
Oh, dear Lord, everything on the table has a shot. Actually, the only one that's kind of questionable is the TIE Fighter.
Captain Rex.
Captain Rex might be a little bit out of range. But otherwise, yeah.
It's a trap!
That Decimator's got a bad day.
Yep, good thing he fires first.
He just flew right into the Rebel trap.
Yep. Well, that's R4-D6. Biggs will only take maximum of 2 damage.
2 damage in 1 turn. So Biggs is guaranteed three turns. And most likely four.
Yeah.
Or more.
That makes it really hard to kill. It seems like it'd be easy, but you have to hit that thing several times, even with only four. Because if he does it right, he's only taking two damage, maximum.
And he's got two of eight dice. So, I mean, it takes a little while to punch something through on him.
Ah! Oh, four. He was in range one. And Predator. One.
Did he get something off the table?
He used his integrated astromech. He flipped it over.
So Biggs is barely alive.
Barely alive. Yep. And Rex doesn't have a shot, so his minus one went away.
Yeah.
Okay, who's firing now? Oh, Biggs with four. Spending the target lock. They all have him target locked, too. That's bad.
It's a bad day. Well, if you've got a hot chart co-pilot, you're going to use target locks instead of focuses. Normally, focus is a better choice than target lock. But...
There we go. He gets it back.
Well, I think it was on Riot originally.
Yeah. Yeah.
So this is the first time
he's had.
And because Chirno has pilot skill, it's not going to be till next turn that it matters. Assuming you...
He should have been able to... I thought with Rex, the Decimator should have been able to roll the defense dice. Did you see him?
Yeah, but...
He didn't get to roll a defense dice.
No, he did. Yeah, he should have had at least one dice.
A crit. Oh, that's bad.
Well, Cherno is not long for this world.
No. My goodness, look at all that.
I'll tell you, that's how Decimators play.
Yep. You just take the damage and hope you can knock stuff out. It's hard with five ships after you.
So the prototype's at range two, though. Oh, he's down to three. Is he going to get another turn?
I don't know.
The prototype's the last one to shoot, so yeah. He's got one more turn. Three hole left. On a Decimator. Oh, Lord. Lordy, lordy. He's got no... There's no way.
He's
got
to go four forward unless he gets blocked.
He's got three hole left on Decimator, and there are five ships on the other side of the table.
Yeah.
So be it if Biggs has one health.
He won't get a shot on Biggs next turn. I don't think he will.
I can't see it. How would he not? Because Biggs is right here. He's right between those asteroids pointing straight at him at range one.
If I were playing Biggs, I would position him in front of the Decimator so the Decimator would bump him and therefore he wouldn't get a shot on him.
Touché.
Maybe.
Use Biggs as the bumper. Use
Biggs as the bumper, because he's only got one left.
Try to keep Biggs out there to conserve MOV, yeah? I mean, the prototype can come in and do bumping, too. Because the thing about Biggs is Biggs has three shots. And the Decimator's a popsicle, and Biggs's is five. So if the Decimator blows up Biggs, he's dead before he gets to shoot.
Yeah.
Now, I think he's...
He is blocking.
He's blocking with the prototype. Or trying to block with the prototype. I don't know if that's going to be a... Big Scott Bart.
Ooh.
Oh, that's not good.
Yeah, hopefully the Decimator does four forward. Otherwise, he's hurting.
Yeah.
Decimator needs to clear as many of those arcs as possible.
Four forward would do it.
You don't think he's going to snap those two in there, do hard turns? And
he can't. He's not going to be able to make a hard turn. Well, yeah. I mean, he's going to put them in the way, but it's still not going to block his four.
Where's this guy going to land? He fits?
No, he's going to bump. Oh, and he's on the asteroid.
Oh! Which green pilot? Is that the one without damage or not?
I don't know. Let's see. Yeah, I don't know.
I was thinking of three banks the right move for the Decimator, but...
Well, let's see what he does. I would have done four forward. Yeah, barrel rolling over. In case he does get four forward, he'll got a shot on him.
Yeah, definitely.
He'll get a shot on him.
And then he'll guarantee the suppressing fire. Three hard. Oh no, Biggs did a three hard.
Yeah, well, that's what I was talking about, hoping he'd bump, right? If he didn't do a four hard, he's going to bump into Biggs, and that saves Biggs.
That's about the best position Biggs has to make a bump. No way he can get out way out in front to make a bump.
I hope he did four forward.
Biggs and Rex will get a shot on him if he does do four forward, though. Well, he may be still out.
He did four forward.
Yeah, I don't know. I would have probably hit that asteroid. That would have been really bad.
He's going to get a shot on somebody. He might take one off. I think the one closest to him is...
Would you Kylo?
At this point?
Kylo Biggs would blinded pilot?
Well, you're going to have to hit Biggs. He's going to have to go after him. Yeah, I would Kylo Biggs. That way if I get any shot... Well, it doesn't matter if... No, I would not Kylo Biggs. I would target lock Biggs. Because if... To get the reroll...
He's got one dice from Predator reroll.
Right. Wonder what he did. He didn't take the target lock.
I think you put Kylo on Biggs right now. And then he's going to modify... Hopefully...
Biggs is gone.
Yeah, well...
25 points. He already had, I'll show you the dark side on Biggs from the previous turn.
So he got one. Oh, so he did kill one ship.
He did kill one ship, yeah. Unfortunately, the prototype pilot does have arc on him. Maybe just barely. What do you think?
He may have a couple arcs on him now that I think about it. That's why I was thinking he should have done a bank. Even if he hit the asteroid, I think it would have been less painful than having the A-Wings have arc on him. I mean, he's in a turn fight. Decimator's going to lose a turn fight to A-Wings. Sorry.
Yep. They're checking for the arc.
Yep.
Nope. No arc.
Back to dolls.
One dial, two dial, three dial.
Well, at least Ben has an easy time of putting the dials down.
Yeah.
He can't complain as he had to think a lot in this game.
That's true. I think I'd do it. What would you do here for the Decimator? I would probably do three hard.
Three hard.
To the right.
You're in trouble.
Well, the problem is he can probably because Captain Rex is going to move first. He can move in and block him. Right?
Do you think Captain Rex can reach out that far?
Yeah.
With a five straight?
Well, if he's doing a three hard.
Yeah, but I don't know if Captain Rex can get. I don't think he can get there.
You don't think so?
I don't think he's got the reach to make it over there.
A five and then a barrel roll, I think, would do it. Five forward and a barrel roll to the right would put him in.
I think this is going to land him on that asteroid there. I don't think it's going to get a block. I don't think he's going to go far enough. Really don't. I don't think Captain Rex has a viable block.
Really? Okay.
I don't think he can get there.
Okay.
I don't think anything can get there, to be honest, to get a block on him this turn.
We'll see what happens.
I mean, a block would be useful because it would keep a...
This is weird, you know? Ben should be the one... Oh, he's going to parroll over? Really?
Does he have space to... I think he's marking chips.
Oh, okay. Oh my god, did it fit?
No. That's why they're having to back up and figure out where it actually ends up. That's really
bad. He's going to hit his own ship.
Yeah, it's really bad because that ship's not going to have arc on the decimator if it does a three hard.
Yeah. That's bad.
Well, I mean, it's a prototype.
One of four.
It's a prototype pilot. That's the one that has nothing but chart and refit. So that's not a huge deal, not having those two attack dice. I mean, you don't want to ever lose dice, but if you got to lose two attack dice,
okay.
It's not a huge
problem. Oh, what? No. Why is he rolling? Did he land on the asteroid? Why is he rolling a die? Oh, it must have been, it's for the, I'll show you the dark side. I think, right? Console fire? Is that a pilot?
No, it's not.
Then why did he roll a die?
That's a good question. Yeah.
That's strange.
He put an evade on... He did. He put an evade on Captain Rex.
So he's gonna have it hard.
Three ships to shoot at him. Oh, boy.
Yeah, he did an easy. He didn't do a hard. That's not good. Oh, I think a hard would have... Is that an asteroid just behind there?
Yeah.
Okay, so that's why he didn't do a three hard.
Well, a three... I don't know. A three bank gets him more range.
That's true. All right. I wonder if he's going after... Who is he going after? Oh, what's he doing for his action? I can't tell that either. Oh, show you the dark side.
Show you the dark side. On... Oh, that was a bad mistake.
Yeah, no. See, I would have taken a target lock.
I'd have done it to this green pilot.
Yeah, that's true.
Because you get a crit on him, he's dead.
He's dead, yeah.
And all you got to push through is one crit.
Yeah.
He's got an evade token on him.
Yeah, that.
Yeah, that cancels out an attack dice, but that's kind of a long shot at this point.
It's range two. Range two. Ooh.
Oh, no.
The Predator, you can reroll one of them. He's hoping for an eyeball and a crit is what he's hoping for.
Is he thinking to change the, he doesn't have Pout. He's got Gunner. I think he's debating.
Well, he has to roll.
Okay, he was able to convert that to a crit. Did he blink?
I can't tell.
He used his evade token. He didn't take anything.
Gunner.
And now he's gunnering it.
And predatoring it, three hits. A hit, two hits and a crit. Takes the crit, so he gets that show you the dark side. Which means if he did the one where he can't fire,
ooh,
that's really good.
He took
good.
Two.
He took two hits? Captain Rex took two hits. Okay. Well, hopefully he did the one where he can't fire.
Yeah. Which will save him from the
He'll have two range three attempts.
But he won't get if he does blinded pilot. Oh.
Yeah, see, so they skipped Rex because it was blinded pilot. But he's doing spinning his target lock. They both got target lock on
it. It saves him from suppressing fire.
One, so he, yeah. Ooh. He took one hit.
Oh,
now the other guy, because the other one's got target lock on him too.
He's got two ships at one hole.
Two hits. This could be it unless he evades. He does not evade.
Blank.
I think that's it.
Decimator's off the table.
That's it. Well, that was quick work again. Slice a dicer.